Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends. In this video, we will study the loss of charge method which is used for the measurement of high resistances. High resistances are those resistances which are of the order greater than 100 kilo ohms or 0.1 mega ohms. So let us start with our topic. High resistances, as I have said, that these are resistances which are of the order greater than 100 kilo ohms or 0.1 mega ohm. They are categorized as the high resistance. There are various examples of high resistances like insulation resistance of cables and machines, and also the high resistance circuits like vacuum tubes. They will also have high resistance in them. Leakage resistance of the capacitors, volume resistivity and surface resistivity of a material. All these are examples of high resistances. Now, there are various methods for the measurement of high resistance like direct deflection method, loss of charge method, Megger method and Megohm method. Here we will study the loss of charge method. In the loss of charge method, the unknown resistance which we want to measure, that is connected in parallel with a capacitor and an electrostatic voltmeter. So voltmeter, it measures the voltage across the resistance, okay, and through the readings of the voltage and the current we will measure the unknown resistance. First, the capacitor, it is allowed to charge through a voltage, that is battery is connected, and through the battery the capacitor, it is allowed to be charged. After that, when the capacitor is charged to some voltage, then the battery will be disconnected and capacitor is allowed to discharge through this unknown resistance. Okay, so the relationship of the discharge or the loss of charge in the capacitor, through that we can calculate the unknown resistance. That is why this method is called loss of charge method, because here we are studying the charging and discharging of a capacitor to some specific voltage. So the circuit for this loss of charge method is, we are having a capacitor. Unknown resistance is there. Capacitor is connected in parallel with this unknown resistance. Then we have an electrostatic voltmeter which is used to measure the voltage across the resistor and the capacitor. Then we have a switch over here. This switch is used to connect or disconnect this battery, which is providing the EMF to the capacitor. Now when this switch is closed, then this capacitor C, it is allowed to be charged to some voltage V. Okay, now after that this switch is open. When this switch is open, the battery is disconnected from the circuit and this capacitor, it is allowed to discharge through this unknown resistance. And this voltmeter, it is measuring the charging and the discharging voltage across the capacitor. Now this charging and discharging of the capacitor, that can be expressed in the form of an expression. So the terminal voltage which is obtained across the capacitor during the discharging of the capacitor, that is expressed as capital V, that is the voltage of the battery, which is equal to small v, that is the reading of the voltmeter, exponential of minus t by CR. T is the time taken for the capacitor to get completely discharged. Okay, so V is the EMF of the battery. And small v is the voltmeter reading. So there is a relationship between the discharging voltage and the EMF of the battery, and here we are having that expression. So using that expression, we can find out the ratio capital V by small v equals to exponential of minus t by CR. If we draw the graph for it, then the capacitor will be charged to that voltage, to some voltage V, and then the discharging is done. So this discharging is in the form of a decreasing exponential. Okay, so this is the decreasing potential. In this way, the voltage will be, or the capacitor will be discharged. Now, through this expression, we can find out the insulation resistance, that is capital R. So from that expression, capital V upon small v is equals to exponential minus t by CR, we can find out the value of the insulation resistance R, and it is equal to t upon C log to the base E capital V by small v. When we calculate this, it is equal to 0.4343 t divided by C log to the, because when we are converting this log to the base E to the base 10, it will be like this. Okay, so through this formula, we can find out the value of the insulation resistance by using the loss of charge method. Now, if the resistance R which we are measuring, it is very large as compared to the value of that capacitor, so this whole process, it becomes very time consuming, okay, and also errors can occur in it, because if more time is taken for the measurement, then there are some factors which can affect the value of the unknown resistance. So if the resistance is very large, the process becomes time consuming, and instead of measuring this voltage across the capacitor, what we measure the difference between the voltages. So the difference between the voltages, that is capital V minus small v, that is calculated. So the formula now, it will becomes So the formula now changes to 0.4343 t divided by C log to the base 10 capital V upon capital V minus E, where E is the small difference. Okay, so This is the new formula for measuring the unknown resistance through this method. Now, this loss of charge method, it is applicable for the measurement of high resistance. Now, there are some cases in which the leakage resistance of the capacitor, which we are using in this method, that leakage resistance is of a value which is comparable to the value of the unknown resistance. So, when the leakage resistance of the capacitor is also very high, then we use a different arrangement for the measurement of the unknown resistance. So the loss of charge method, it measures the resistances. It requires that the capacitor which is used in the measurement, that capacitor should have a leakage resistance which is of very high value as compared to the value of the unknown resistance, so that no leakage currents are produced. So in that discharging, we have to consider that leakage resistance also of the capacitor. Okay, so here we have the two resistance. One is the resistance of the, one is the leakage resistance of the capacitor, and another is the unknown resistance. So suppose that let L1 is the leakage, R1 is the So here R1 is the leakage resistance of the capacitor and R dash is the equivalent resistance of R and the R1. So if we write the value of this equivalent resistance, because R and R1, they are connected in parallel with each other, so R dash will be equals to R into R1 upon R plus R1. That will be the equivalent resistance. Now suppose again the switch is closed and the capacitor, it is allowed to charge to a suitable voltage V, which is provided by this battery. So when the switch is closed, the capacitor will be charged to the voltage V. Now the switch is open and the capacitor, it is allowed to get discharge. So in that case, the discharge equation, as what we have written earlier, that discharge equation will become as, instead of the unknown resistor, now we are having that equivalent resistance connected here. This switch is also closed, this is closed. R and R1, they are replaced by this equivalent resistance R dash. So capacitor is going to get discharged through this R dash equivalent resistance. So equivalent resistance is given by the same equation, 0.4343 T divided by C log to the base 10 capital V by small v. Okay, discharge equation has changed and this R dash is the equivalent resistance, that is R1 upon R plus R1. Now in the second case, this switch is open and this switch is also open and capacitor, it is allowed to get discharge through this leakage resistance R1. R1 is the leakage resistance of the capacitor. So now the capacitor, it is going to get discharged through this. In the first case, it was discharging through that equivalent resistance. In the second case, it is discharging through this leakage resistance only. So the discharge equation, it will be changed. It will now be R1 equals to 0.4343 T divided by C log capital V by small v. Okay, so from these two equation and the equation R dash equals to R1 upon R plus R1, we can get the value of the leakage resistance of the capacitor also and the unknown resistance also. So this loss of charge method, when the leakage resistance of the capacitor, it is very high as compared to this unknown resistance which we want to measure, then we are going to consider this leakage resistance also. We cannot neglect it. And the first equation which we obtained earlier, that is used in the case when the leakage resistance is not so high and it can be neglected. So this is the loss of charge method which is used for the measurement of high resistances which are of the order of 100 kilo ohms or greater than 0.1 mega ohm. Okay, so I hope that this topic, measurement of high resistances using loss of charge method, is clear to you. Thank you.